Hi, I'm Pernille. Today we're in our home in Copenhagen, where I live with my husband and 4 kids. This is our kitchen. Even though it doesn't look like it, we actually do a lot of food in this kitchen. We wanted to have everything hidden away, so you don't really see any kind of, oven or fridge. For me, it's cool that, you know, that the kitchen becomes like a part of the living room space, and it's not a traditional kitchen, but more like a conversation place, and also a place where you make food, of course. This piece is made by a Danish artist called Thomas Foss Poulsen, and he created this for the Celine stores when Phoebe Philo was there. And I love this tray. I think it's so beautiful because of the brass, but together with the colorful, very organic shapes glass, it just creates such a cool contrast again.
It just needs to heat up.
After spending like tons of years buying coffee from nearly every coffee spot in Copenhagen, we decided to get our own coffee machine. And if I have to say it, I think my husband makes the best coffee I've ever had, which is quite big of a compliment. So now we're in our living room, definitely one of my favorite rooms. I have 3 small boys, and I thought it would be really fun to create something that reflects on that a bit, and a real surprise element. So we've just placed this really beautiful Joel Winston piece here with basketballs. This piece really makes our home more personal, as it was something that, you know, you would not really put together. And I think that's very important, that things kind of stand out in a way. The aesthetic from the living room that we wanted to create was, first of all, having a huge table where everyone can be, the whole family. I have 4 kids, so we are a lot just on a daily basis. Having the contrast between something quite minimalistic as the marble table together with the very romantic stucco creates a really cool contrast that I love. I love the contrast between materials. The contrast of materials just makes everything pop even more. I love chairs, and I love vintage chairs. I have great memories of my grandmother sitting in this same chair. It's an Eames lounge chair, and hers were black. Doesn't matter, but I just remember she was sitting in it. But we kind of wanted one here to kind of have that memory of her in the room. And because everything else is white, I thought it would be really cool to find a white one in a soft shell white, together with the mahogany tree on the bottom of it. This is a picture of me and my husband from our wedding almost 6.5 years ago. We got the frame. It's a vintage mirror frame that we got. This picture just brings up so many good memories. Candlesticks on our dining table. Every time we had dinner, my mom used to light the candles. And I do this too at home. I inherit it from my grandparents, so these will be with me forever, I think. This couch is so fun. I'm sure it's the kids' favorite piece of furniture in the house. They love hanging out on it, and they run up and they play, and they have all the toys here. In weekends, we turn it around and we spend a lot of time, you know, with our duvets and, you know, playing cards and stuff in it. It's really, really fun. And because it's black, it's very easy just to wipe off. So yeah, it's really good. Thank you. I would define my style as quite classic, but very tomboy inspired. I've always been drawn by masculine fits, something oversized. And to be honest, like, I've stolen so many things from my husband during the years, like jeans and shirts and stuff, because I really love, like, how, you know, as a female, you can even look even more feminine wearing masculine outfits. So that is, again, a contrast that I really love to kind of explore. These are vintage Levi's, and they're so old that they're almost falling apart. They will never leave my wardrobe. I really love them. It's like that wash you just can't find anywhere. So yeah, and then they just fit really well. Bomber jacket, actually I found it on a flea market years ago. It has that really cool sporty vibe that I really love. So I think that is really cool with, you know, a pair of jeans or even like on top of a dress or something to kind of pare things down. And lastly, I have a dress from Celine, which is the old Celine, people would say. But yeah, I think I have a whole archive of things that she did. This is definitely a dress that I will wear with a pair of flat sandals to tone it down, because I believe that you can wear, you know, long dresses for everyday use as well. I love our office. It's like, you know, the place where I kind of, you know, hide away in my creative thoughts. This is one of my latest, biggest fashion memories. Cover with Vogue Scandinavia, where I was pregnant with my daughter. I was 7-8 months pregnant here. Remember, I was really tired and exhausted. It was a really long day, but it's definitely a shoot I will never forget. To me, the balance between work and motherhood is still a balance that I have not learned yet. You have to remember to have yourself within all the things that you do. And if you're happy with things that you do, you can feel it on the kids as well. Proud wife moment. I've thought about launching my own brand, but not in fashion. If we would do it, it would definitely be something else. So maybe something is in the pipeline. I cannot reveal yet. We're in our bathroom, and as you see, it's quite minimal. I've always been quite a fan of travertine stone. It's super subtle, but still there is a playfulness to the surface that is super interesting. I don't have much time to do my beauty routines, so everything I do has to be quite fast. So I use a few products every day. One of my go-to products is the serum from BioEffect. I use it both for day and night. Sometimes, like, the only product that I use, because it applies a lot of moisturize to my skin, and I think that it gives such a nice glow. And second one is a Danish brand called Honey. It's a body oil that I apply when I've been to the shower and before I, you know, dry myself. I apply it so it kind of, you know, goes to the skin quite fast and dries up. But it's really nice, and it's, you know, certified organic. And to me, when I've been breastfeeding and, you know, being pregnant, it's important for me to wear products that are without anything in it. And then I have another cream that I use sometimes in, like, a facial cream. It's very rich, because when you live in a country where it's really cold, your skin dries out quite fast. So for me, you know, moisturize is key.